solution. That is why we are protesting today, because let me tell you the implication of removing the minimum wage from the exclusive list to the concurrent list. It then means that every governor, every employer will go and pay what he wants. Which means there is no room for collective bargaining. They will go and pay slave wages and say that it has been removed from the constitution. That is the implication. A worker will rise up and collect far less than even 10,000. That is what we must fight. We must be ready to fight it, because that is what they want to do. And therefore, this is our fundamental right. Every worker in the world has a right to a minimum wage. That is the standard set by the International Labour Organization. As we speak today, if they are talking of federalism, in 26 federal states, they have national minimum wage. America is a federation, while all the 50 states are semi-autonomous. But America today has a minimum wage of $10 per hour. The current president, President Biden, who is a friend of the workers, said he's going to increase it to $15 per hour. If you calculate that and compare with our minimum wage, is our minimum wage anything to go by?
No!
So progressive leaders around the world are thinking of how to increase the minimum wage and address poverty among the working class. But in our own case, our politicians see us as the problem, whereas they are the problem. They must remove the lock in their own eyes before coming to remove just the mere fact in our eyes. That is what we are demanding. If you are talking of a standard, minimum wage is a global standard set by the International Labour Organization, whereas the salary of our politicians that they are earning, which is among us, is a Nigerian standard. So let us consider the international standard. If you are talking of federalism, that because of federalism, everybody should go and fix salary, that is wrong. I say authoritatively that 26 federal states around the world have national minimum wage. Let me also posit that 90% of ILO countries have national minimum wage. As I speak to you today, Europe is considering a uniform minimum wage across the entire Europe, because they understand the fact that there will be labor migration from areas where there are low wages to areas where there are higher wages, and they don't want that to happen. And that's why they are considering a uniform minimum wage for every worker in Europe. They have a standard, and that is the standard that I think should guide Nigerians. We cannot reduce ourselves or our politicians reduce us to a standard that is not a standard. And let me also say that President Muhammadu Buhari must take the opportunity of history. Shehu Shagari gave Nigerian workers minimum wage of 125 naira, which then you remember that a naira was almost equivalent to a dollar. So we are talking of $125, which was then equivalent to the minimum wage of 125 naira. 40 years down the line, and I remembered also progressive governors then were among the first to start implementation. Kaduna was one of them, late Malarabe Musa. You also remembered late Remy, the ambassador of change. Remy was among them, and Latif Jakande was among them. All the progressive governors were among those governors that said, no, our workers must receive the best. You remember the history of minimum wage? It started from Kano and Kaduna. They declared 1st May minimum national holiday for workers even before the national government actually coming. So that is the standard that have been established. How can we 40 years down the line try to now bring down the bar because we have selfish group of politicians? Shame to them. These are the facts we have confronted them with. Comrades, these are the facts we have confronted them with. And they could not respond to those facts, because these are facts that are incontrastable. Those are facts that are reality, well documented. And that is why today we said we will have to demonstrate to the National Assembly, because National Assembly is where every one of us is represented.
Yes.
Every constituency is represented.
Yes.
The member representing me is there, I will inform him. If he does otherwise, he knows also my reaction and the reaction of our people. In most of our places, workers are opinion leaders.
Yes.
And therefore, we must utilize that opportunity.
Yes.
Educate them properly.
Yes,
the implication of this action. And let us work together assiduously to ensure that they don't achieve this nefarious act. Comrades, let me salute you. And before we move, we have our leaders that are here, President and General Secretaries, because I've said
You cannot have a general on a war day you are sleeping in your house. You are no longer a general. We will remove you and put somebody there to
yes,
look. Because every union will identify you. Every union.
Yes, sir.
We are aware that many unions, in fact, I am aware that one union was here as early as 7:20. The first union to arrive here, Ratahu. Ratahu, we are here as early as possible. Ratahu, I said, well done. I've seen all unions, but we are going to take inventory. We'll call roll call union by union before we now start. And before we do that, I'm going to invite our presidents and general secretaries that are here to speak to the crowd before we then arrange ourselves and before the organizing come and identify unions that are here and also our civil society allies that are here with us. The TUC is here with us. The president is almost here. We just spoke with him. We left the office to protect the interests of workers. We have already written to the leadership of the National Assembly, both the Senate President and the Speaker, to say that we are visiting them today. Nigerian workers will be visiting them today to actually present our protest letter. We wrote to them on the 8th, and that letter has been acknowledged. So I hope they will be at hand to receive us, because that is the house of Nigerian people. It is our house, and that is why it's called the House of Representatives. President Construction Union, can you speak to your people?
Solidarity forever! Comrades, I want to join the President in appreciating the turn up this morning. And I don't want to miss the issue because the President's presentation was apt and straight to the point. In advocating further, I want to join voice to say that the anti-workers move that is being initiated at the National Assembly is unacceptable and will be resisted with all fairness. Labour is resolute in this move. And I want to remind us at any time we fail to take our responsibility, especially at the time when it's needed most, where you will register weakness and freedom, and that is stand against you in the history of time to come. And therefore, we are calling on everyone here to be law abiding citizens. The President has told you protest is legitimate. It's our right to do so any day, any time. This protest is not just taking place in Abuja. Is taking place all over the nation, and we are willing and we are ready to enforce such protests. Now today, in the short while, we will be moving like the President has directed, but just to tell you one thing, when we talk about minimum wage, we're talking about our rights, we're talking about our welfare, we're talking about salary that is not at the discretion of the employer. Salary is a legitimate earning by those that work for it. And therefore, President, I've told you, and I'm saying it again, that the size of workforce in Nigeria is the size of Nigeria. Without the workers, the nation cannot move. And today, we are going to register evidence of our strength. Forward
ever.
I want my colleagues to speak to this. We are grateful to have you. God bless you.
Solidarity. I'm happy to now introduce the President of Trade Union Congress, Comrade Kadri Olalewe, who is here with us. Let me also stress the point. We are not protesting against the International Assembly because the bill was not sponsored by the National Assembly. The bill was sponsored by an individual, who is an individual member, who is also being supported by 9 governors. That we have it authoritatively. So basically, we are also aware, even on the floor, some of our very progressive lawmakers stood up to actually speak against the bill.
Yes.
And their position was well captured. And therefore, we must commend those members of the House of Rep. We are going to come up with name and shame thing.
Yes.
We are also going to appreciate those that stood by Nigerian workers. So this is the fact that we must put across. Let me therefore give the microphone to my colleague, President of the Trade Union Congress, to also say a word or two to all of us and also energize us. Great Nigerian workers.
Yes.
Solidarity, Aluta,
come inside.
Comrade, let me ask you these questions.
Is it true that some states have not implemented the minimum wage?
Yes!
Is it true that some state governments have decided to cut your salaries?
Yes!
Comrades, if that is true, is it true that some state governors have also sponsored a member of the House to move our salary from exclusive to concurrent?
Yes!
So what are we waiting for? What are we waiting for? We know those governors. And the only way we can tell them we are on ground is to show our action, mobilize to that House, and let them bring out the sponsor of that bill. I think that is what we are here for. If that is the reason, let us march straight to meet that sponsor of that bill. And let us also broadcast the name of those governors that have been cutting our salaries, that have refused to pay minimum wage. By the time we are done with them, they will know the importance of Nigerian workers. Solidarity, Aluta, forward ever.
Comrades, we have area of our leadership here. I've seen the deputy president. I've seen also the president of Nupeng and vice president. The president of ASU, our intellectual boss, is here. The president of Nuflampe, the chemical union. The president of nurses and midwives. The president of OPTA, all the unions, they are here. So we'll give them an opportunity actually to speak briefly to Nigerian workers before we start to move. So let me call the vice president of NNC, who is also the president, National Union of Petroleum and Natural Gas Workers, Comrade Williams.
Thank you, Governor Pezzo.
He's for Leto! He Africa! He's Trago! Victoria!
We are meant to understand that we are running a democracy. And what we understand democracy to be is that it's supposed to be a government for the people. And once, if democracy is a government of the people, then it shouldn't be against the people. And any politician that goes to our National Assembly, I want to come out with laws that are against the people. Mr. Nakpako, politician be that. We call on Zaria constituency, where this man represents, to withdraw that representative. That is not what it's of. Nigerian workers shall stand against this unworthy policy that is against the people, that is against Nigerian workers. Nupeng as an organization, we continue to stand by NLC on struggles of this nature. And you can continue to count on us. In Soweto, in Africa, the struggle, in getting the world.
Thank you. Thank you, President. You know, in the health sector, we also have a very strong union, National Association of Nigerian Nurses and Midwives. And you know that when services are withdrawn, you are sure that the health sector will be closed down. So let me call on the President, National Association of Nigerian Nurses and Midwives, to say a word. And the President of ASU, our intellectual brain box, should be on standby to speak to us. Greatest Congress, our global president has spoken our mind, and I want to inform us here that we are together in solidarity to represent our people. But it is important for me to remind you of one thing. We go to the same market to buy food commodities, fuel, NEPA, and all forms of activities of human nature. We go to the same place. Now look at a situation whereby our government is finding it difficult to pay 20,000 naira minimum wage. One should be sincere to ask himself, how much do I really spend in a day? What about these various families that have a lot of people depending on them? I think that leadership is all about the people. If the leadership is all about the people, and you are not representing those people, then you are merely on your own. I see no reason why this type of situation should be allowed to exceed more than today. I think standing together, that bill has to be withdrawn today.
and let the masses be addressed. If you don't attend to the people you are leaving, what you doing? We should go home to think about, are we really leading the people or leading ourselves? Therefore, just as soap is important for food, the workers are important both for the government, and they deserve everything good. Global President, we are together, we are with you. Thank you so much, and continue the solidarity. Thank you.
Thank you very much, comrades. As we are moving, we'll be stopping, and we'll be taking address from all our leadership, President and General Secretaries. Every one of them will speak. But usually, it's on our way going, there are points that we will have to stop, allow them to speak before we get to the destination. Let me then invite the President, Academic Staff Union of Universities, the Prof himself, to take up the microphone and give us the intellectual perspective.
Great Nigerian workers, workers of the greater Nigerian workers, solidarity, solidarity, yes, thank you so much, leaders.
Hospitals. So, comrades, it
It is now enlightened self-interest. It is in me. It is in our enlightened self-interest to resist this move. Because to fail to do so is to enter into another round of collective jeopardy. We are not going to allow it. Are we going to allow it?
No.
So comrades, are we going to support this struggle?
Yeah.
Are we going to support this struggle?
Yeah.
You can always count on our union. ASU will be there to walk to side by side of workers. Thank you very much. The struggle continues.
Yes, sir.
Thank you very much, Prof. I think lastly, I will allow two persons to speak, then we move forward. The president of SANU and then the president of OPTA. Then others will speak as we go forward. Also, I think it's important, I saw the general secretary of TUC. As we go, as we move, everybody will be given opportunity. So 2 minutes, please, SANU.
Thank you. Greetings, Nigerian workers. Greetings, Nigerian workers. Forever. Thank you very much, our global president. Our leaders have spoken, and they have spoken very well. I have very short message for us all here. And what I'm trying to say is that we all have our constituencies. The global president has told us that we have our representatives in the National Assembly. We must make sure that we go back, call for town hall meetings, and threaten our representatives that they must not take part in the passage of this bill. And if they do, then they must remain in the National Assembly, but not go back to their villages. Are we all in this together? Yeah. Nigerian workers! Thank you.
President OPTA, then Vice President Tribunal Congress, last
my route.
Before we start to move.
Okay. Because I go need
this Soweto, the Africa, Congress, there's one thing that we don't, or many people don't know. Nigerian politician has made in this country a business venture.
Yes.
They call it Nigeria Limited. And whatsoever that is happening here, they are thinking of the gate. And that is why you will see or you will hear them rolling up billions every month, every week, and you don't know where the money is entering. Poverty is ravaging the nation. And now, the last thing they want to do is to pocket us. We will resist it.
Yes.
This dirty man, we are going to resist him to his house. His family, we are going to call them to resist and reject him in totality. He is against humanity. And those who supported him, they are against humanity. We are in support of this struggle, and we stand with the Labour Centre for that. Thank you.
Thank you very much. We have the Vice President Trade Union Congress, a very strong alliance of NLC. Please speak to our people.
Greetings, Nigerian workers. Greetings, Nigerian workers. You know, a day like this is a memorable day for Nigerian workers. I know many of us have spoken so well on this, but there's one aspect I want us to address. You know, these National Assembly members, what they do is that you will never hear they are lacking their money. You will never hear they are not getting their salary. Even their workers, their own workers, are not paying. Because they receive the workers' money in their own money. Now, part of what we shall be adding to this struggle today is that their own salary should be paid by the own state governor.
Yes.
Their salary should be taken to the state government so that they will feel the pain. Many of our members in the state don't get their salary. They don't get, sometimes they pay 10, 20, 30, 40%. But you never hear it from them. So, what we shall be asking is that let the constitution be amended so that Enugu state rents will be paid by Enugu state government.
Yeah.
Lagos state rents should be paid by Lagos state rents so that they will feel the pain Nigerian workers feel.
Yes.
Because the population of our members in the state who are suffering is far too much. And so we are here already and we are going to support our leadership. The presidents are here to go and make a statement. There are the three armed zones.
Do you support this?
Yes.
Are you energized?
Yes.
Solidarity? Let them also be on minimum wage and see if they will survive. Because we go to the same market. General Secretary TUC, lastly, will take two prayers. Let our prayer warriors be ready. Let me see your hand if you are led. We'll take two prayers and pray for the repose of our colleagues at the General Secretary Medical and Health Workers Union of Nigeria that had a ghastly motor accident around Kaduna. We pray for them before we take off. GS, Trade Union Congress from Elawa.
Solidarity. The society is protected by law and order, and also by morality. Sometimes, what is legal may not be expedient. And at other times, what is expedient may not be legal. But our fight today is both legal and expedient. Therefore, you are under the protection of law. Go ahead. God bless you all.
Lastly, comrade, before we take off, because we believe also in the power of the Almighty, we will pray. Those two colleagues will also pray for the repose of the soul of our colleagues, the General Secretary of Medical and Health, that died in a ghastly motor accident 2 days ago in Kaduna, himself and the wife and the daughter. So they will give us prayer. Yes. And also prayer for Nigerian workers, and then we start to move. We are going to move in a very organized manner. We are going to allow social distancing. We shouldn't congest in one place because we will take over the city. Is that okay? Is that okay? And allow our leaders also to be in the front. Thank you very much, comrades. Let me therefore invite, we have Pastor Rotimi here, of the Redeemed Church of God, and is the accountant of the Nigerian Labour Congress. Can you pray for us, Pastor?
Let somebody shout hallelujah.
Hallelujah!
Whenever the masses are maltreated, God gets angry in heaven. This proposal is from the pit of hell. And the anger of God will catch up with every author of it in the name of Jesus. I want you to lift up your voice to the Most High and say, Father, every evil politician that will not allow the workers in Nigeria to have rest of mind, let your anger rest on them in the name of Jesus Christ. Politician who have no interest of the workers and the people of Nigeria that elected them, we release an order from above today. Let the anger of the Lord swallow them in the name of Jesus. We declare from today that they will have no peace. As they disorganize us in our place of war, ever we disorganize them in the name of Jesus. By force, salary is our right, is our entitlement.
Yes.
Father, by violence, we receive it back in the name of Jesus.
Yes.
Father, help Nigeria. Help Nigeria. Help Nigeria. Help Nigeria. In the name of Jesus. When a man like idea, he will begin to do things that provoke the people. Every thinker of this nation that are thinking upside down, oh Lord, send them packing in the name of Jesus. Please, we pray for the family of our comrade. Lord, encourage them. Fill the vacuum and let your name alone be glorified. We will hear the testimony of this prayer very, very soon. In the mighty name of Jesus. Thank you, Father. In Jesus' mighty name we are praying.
Thank you very much. SANU President, are you around? SANU President. Come on fire
Labor.
From the Islamic perspective.
Ambassador.
Salut à Nabi al-Karim.
Allahumma salli ala Muhammad.
Ya Allah, we pray to you. We pray that our oppressors shall not succeed.
Amen.
We pray that all our detractors will not succeed.
Amen.
We also pray that all those that are Haiti workers will not see their progress.
Amen.
We also pray that our workers in Nigeria will continue to prosper from greater strength to strength.
Amen.
We also pray that, O Lord Almighty,
Amen.
Our departed colleague,
Amen.
We pray for the repose of his soul. We pray that you take care of the family. We pray that you take care of all of us here and those that we are representing. ربنا آتنا في الدنيا حسنة وفي الآخرة حسنة وقنا عذاب النار لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له له الملك وله الحمد وهو على كل شيء قدير سبحان ربك رب العزة عما يصفون وسلام على المرسلين الحمد لله رب العالمين آمين.
May the soul of our departed colleague, General Secretary, Medical and Health Workers Union and the family, come with Salas Adamu rest in perfect peace. Solidarity! So comrades, we are organizers. Please try to organize how we are going to take off. Thank you very much. Thank you, thank you, thank you.
Okay, comrades, we will all stand where we are. We will wait for our leaders to go to the front. Just stand where you are first. Let our leaders move to the front, behind the banner. Okay. Please remain where you are standing. Our leaders will go to the front, then they will lead us on where we will be moving to. Is that understood, comrades? Our leaders will lead.
Comrades, let us stand where you are.
Yes,
why? Sandy, be honey.
Hello.
Come on here now. Come on here, my friend. Come on, you can't even.
You better not bow. They are going like this.
Hey, come here, man. Hey. Come here,
behind the banner.
Can this man hold on your down? Come on, this man. Come on, you leave the place.
Come on, guys.
Come on, friend.
I don't know why you cameraman know the year one.
Mamut.
You cameraman, you know the year one. Just simple instruction.
Is it? Help me with it. Don't take much. Yeah, I know. Don't take much. You are too fast.